Hello students, today we are going to study the second part of the motion and measurements, that is physical quantity and different type of physical quantities. Okay, and also we will going to study units of physical quantity and also different type of physical quantity units. Before this session we understood and we studied about importance of measurement, why the measurement is very much important for us in the daily life. That's where we discussed. Okay, without much delay, we will study today about the physical quantity. Start with. Let me explain about the physical quantity. So anything you touch, feel physically, means I'm touching the pen. This is, I would say, the subject or object. I'm touching it and I'm feeling it. This is a pen. This is a pen. So I'm going to measure this pen with respect to length. I'm going to measure this one with respect to weight. So literally I'm touching it and doing it. So it means you are handling the object with respect to you, touch, by touching and feeling it. So that's where they're called physical quantities. So that's where we are going to calculate the length. That is, a length is nothing but a quantity, and we are touching it and measuring it. The physical quantity is length. We are calculating the mass by touching this pen and seeing it, what is the weight. So that is a physical quantity. So that's where the definition says here that anything, okay, touch and feel, measure it physically, okay, measure it physically, that is called physical quantities. Okay, now we understood the physical quantities. Okay, what are the list of physical quantities? That's one we are going to discuss now. Several physical quantities in today life. So those are I listed here, nearly 20 physical quantities today what we see on the list. For example, length is a physical quantity. Whatever you take here, density, whatever you take, electric current, pressure, velocity, several things, all these are physical quantities. And you know, we will use this physical quantity to analyze the practical scenarios of problem, and then it will help us to solve the examples. So that's where these physical quantities will help a lot. So now let me go a little bit next level. We have totally two type of physical quantities. That is, one is fundamental physical quantities, another one is derived physical quantities. Okay, what do you mean by fundamental? What do you mean by derived? Let me explain with small example. Okay, fundamental, let us first. Fundamental is not dependent on anything. It has its own source. Okay, it is not prepared by anything. It is its own. Okay, it is independent. It is not dependent at all. That is a fundamental. Coming to the next, derived. Derived is the one where we use fundamental and prepare a product. Prepare it. That is derived. For example, let me take a preparation of tea. We need water. We need milk. We need sugar. We need tea powder. These four are called physical quantities and belongs to fundamental. Water is different. Okay. Milk is different. Sugar is different, tea powder is different. All are independent. They all are four fundamentals. I would say here fundamental quantities. Okay. Now we put all together, make a tea. There is only one tea, one cup of tea. It's a mixture of all these four quantities. So that is derived one. Okay. That is derived one. So this is a best example to explain about. So now coming to the our physical quantities, we have totally 20 list. In that, which one is belongs to fundamental, which one is belongs to derived? Let's see that one. Okay, we have a list here. What you see on screen is length, you know, the length, mass, time, temperature, electric current, luminosity, plane angle, amount of substance, solid angle, electrical potential. All these are fundamentals. On the other side, you will find a derived quantities, because these, all these, you know, all these are derived from fundamentals. Derived from fundamentals. Okay, so that's where it is derived, physical quantities. Let me take you to the next one step. What you mean by units? Unit is, you know, they are fixed quantities which are correlates with the physical quantities which we studied so far. And wherever you go, wherever the temperature weather changes, okay, it remains the same. For example, today also same, the unit is same, even in the past also same, even in the future also same. It is a fixed unit, okay, with respect to physical quantity. If you go to any country, the unit remains same for the respective physical quantity. Even if you damage it by giving the temperature something, it does not change its quality. It is remain same. It's a fixed one. So my point here is units are fixed quantities, okay, and they do not change with the time, temperature, place, etc. Okay, they are accepted globally. If you go to any country, if you speak meter, they will understand. If you speak seconds, they will understand. If you speak with respect to your force, they will the Newton, they will understand. Like that, it is a unit. Now here in this unit also, we have two type of units. One is a fundamental unit, another one is a derived units. So let's see those things. The fundamental unit, which is related to fundamental physical quantity unit, and the derived units are the one which are related to derived physical quantities. The fundamental quantity is nothing but length, mass, time. We meet called meter, kilograms, second. The symbol is small m, small k, kg, kilogram, small second, small s, second. Like that, we have a list of fundamental physical quantity unit, and also we have derived here. For example, take acceleration. Okay, acceleration means what? Change in the velocity. Okay, change in the velocity means what? Distance by time. Distance means what? Meter, length, okay, and divided by time. It is a formula where we put in the numerator meter, in the denominator second, that gives the value of velocity. Okay, m is here length, which is available here, and s is also time, which is available here. So we taken from fundamental and we put it into the formula and we found velocity, and this is v. Okay, and this acceleration is change in the velocity, means this is velocity we are taken from here, and time is taken from here. Once again we are taken from s here, so this has become a meter second square. Okay, like this. And you know, there is a several derived units here. You have rho here, symbol is like this. Okay, rho here, volume, it's a milliliter, that's what we call it as. And power, pressure, area, energy, all these are derived physical quantities. Along with that, we see the different units. You see kg here, meter here, second square. You know, we used into the formula and prepared the derived physical quantity and as well as units. So this is all about physical quantity and units. You know where exactly these are useful? I'll tell you when you start solving the problems. Okay, the problem statement, when we read it, we need to analyze the problem statement, we need to interpret it, and we need to put the values using these physical quantity and units. I will go when I go to the problem solving section where I'll explain about these things. So it will help a lot in that area. And these are the very much basic to proceed in the physics and as well as chemistry in the and as well as in the day-to-day life. Okay, this is very much fundamental information. Going to next, we are going to study about different systems of measuring. Okay, what are the different measuring systems we have in the globally? So that's where we are going to study, and which system is accepted globally, that is also we are going to study that one. Okay, without much delay, we will start that one. And I request you to subscribe and like, comment about this session, and how you felt about this session, please comment it. It helps to bring a similar kind of content in the future days. Okay, and thank you very much. We'll see you in the next class.